Hi, Stacee here, and welcome to another edition of Double Dips. For this dip, we're going to upcycle these chargers we got at the thrift store. So let's get going. Houston, we have a problem. I did a paint pour on the charger, and it didn't record for some reason. So I'm going to do a demonstration on a small canvas just so you can see how a paint pour is done. So for a paint pour, you can either use pre-made paints or mix your own using pouring medium and whatever paints you have laying around, which is what I did. You mix it in equal parts, separate colors, and then you take each color and pour it into a cup, one at a time, kind of layer it on there. Then you take that cup and you put whatever you want to pour on top of it upside down, flip it over, and then release the cup. And then you swirl it around on the thing that you want to cover and make designs. Now, I accidentally drop it here, but that actually worked out because it made the design prettier on that. This technique is called a dirty pour, and it is dirty. So if I were you, I would use gloves because this is a freaking mess. I also put a little more on the side to fill in the holes. And here's the charger looked like after I used that technique on it. Once it was dry, I sealed it with Mod Podge spray. So I want to turn this charger into a clock. So first I drilled a hole in it from both sides, and then I fit in the clock part, and then I screwed all the screws on that you're supposed to do. So I put on the clock hands like I was supposed to according to the instructions, and they would not tighten, not at all. And I kept trying to tighten it, and then I somehow broke one of the hands. I turn it slightly sideways and the thing falls over instead of staying where it's supposed to, like a clock should. So I guess I'll have to get another clock part and try again later. I'm quite annoyed. New day, new clock kit, and now we have a working clock. Can you hear it tick? It works! I also got some number stickers, which I added E6000 to, so they would stick better even though they had adhesive already. And I also put a loop on the back with staples and E6000 like I've done in other projects. I love the mid-century vibe. I also think it sort of looks like the sky after it rains. Very pretty. So this project had some technical difficulties and some petty annoyances that almost made me want to chuck it in, but I didn't. So remember, when you're crafting, mistakes happen, things don't turn out the way you wanted, but if you keep going with it, you can often make it work, as Tim Gunn would say. So anyway, thanks for crafting with me today. Have a great one, and I'll see you next time. Bye!